Welcome back, guys. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to use the geometry tool and how to use the optics tool and also your Liquify tool, and then we finalize the video or the retouching by using frequency separation and whitening of the teeth. Alright, so welcome back to the channel. This is ASA Studio, channel for music producers and photographers. So without further ado, let's dive right into it. So the first thing I want to do is to take a look at the photo and see what's actually wrong with the photo. And if I zoom in, you can see a lot of rashes on her face, although that is her skin problem. And also the teeth is actually not white in her eyes, and we need some frequency separation. You can also see that she tilted her head, is not actually horizontal, and the jaw and the cheek are not straight and positioned properly, and also her neck right here not positioned properly. So we're going to be fixing that. So when you come across this in other photos, you can actually use this method to fix those photo. Alright, so let's get started. The first thing first, let's try and straighten her head with the geometry tool in camera raw filter. Alright, so let's go to fix that, go to camera raw filter, which is under filter, camera raw filter. So yeah, I am camera raw filter, and I'm not going to do anything yet, just to go to the geometry tool. You can see the geometry tool below the optics tool. Go to the geometry tool and you actually click horizontal, because it's not going to do anything, it's just going to leave it the way it is. So click on the first one, and then we're going to adjust the positioning of the head. First of all, use the rotate tool and drag it back just a bit, and you can take the horizontal tool and let's drag it forward and backwards, just forward like this. And the vertical tool, we can move it vertically like this to straighten our head. And we're going to balance our head so soon, so let's take this backward to straighten the image, so to get it straight somewhere around there. It might vary in your image, so just look for what's best for you. So I guess this is actually okay for me, and I'm going to click on okay. So I quickly drag in another one so you can see the difference before and then after. You see before and then after. Okay, so I'm going to turn this one off, and we're going to go ahead in using the Liquify tool this time around. So go select the image, the layer, and go to filter, go to Liquify. So here we are in the Liquify tool, and you can pick on the brush, the forward wrap tool, and make it smaller. And this time around, let's first of all balance the way the neck is. Don't mind the way you see it, just balance it, make it, you know, straight like this. Okay, now I'm going to use the face wrap tool, and I'm going to open up this eyes a little bit and push it in so it matches this one. I'm still going to open it just a bit, and also the nose, bring it closer, although we're going to still do some adjusting, bring this closer. Okay, I'm going to make the face, the head, bring this one down a bit, and the jaw, take it up a bit, just a little bit. Okay, so now we can pick up the forward wrap tool again, and we're going to push this cheek inside just small. I'm going to make it bigger and push the top right of our head in. Let's undo that and do it again, just in like that, and this one too, in somewhere around the outside, just to make it look straight. And I'm gonna do for this also just that, okay, to make it straight. And let's make it smaller and push this place just inside, yeah, and push the cheek, this one inside. Okay, all right so I guess we actually good with this one. And now I'm gonna zoom in and take this down and make it smaller, and adjust that side, not the lips. Yeah, just take it up and bring this one closer and down, and also take this one up. So something like that looks fine to me. We can actually balance the nose somewhere around here and push it in, and take this and push it out, and push this out and balance the nose. Okay, so that looks okay. Now I feel we actually done. We can just, you know, cover up this place before we do that later. We're gonna cover it up by in. Okay, so make it smaller and then bring this back in, although I'm gonna fix that later on. Okay, I'm gonna make it bigger and just, you know, quickly cover the sides, and let's zoom out and see. You can also do this, no big deal. So something like this. Okay, so I think I'm gonna make it big and, you know, balance this place a bit. Yeah, so I guess, yeah, and now our hair looks okay. So we can click on okay and we're done with this, and you can see before and then after actually straighten the head. So we can zoom in and crop it, or then out and put it in the middle. I'm still gonna make it bigger like that, and so it actually balance just like this. Okay, so I'm gonna hit okay on the keyboard, and now we can also rotate a little bit. Yeah, and now it's actually straight. Okay, so the next thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna duplicate this, Ctrl J, and I'm gonna merge it with this one, and I see merge layers. Okay, the reason why I'm merging is to correct this place. So I'm just gonna click on this and I'm gonna draw and let's use the patch tool. Now I'm gonna move it down somewhere here, and I'm gonna leave it. So that fixed that already. Ctrl D to deselect, and now we can use the mixer tool brush and we can just, you know, blend it together and blend here also together. Okay, so for this place I'm gonna fix that with the same one, patch tool, but let's select and use the patch tool and move it to somewhere around above. So we can use the mixer tool brush and we can, you know, just drag and paint downwards till we have select. So you can click on Ctrl deselect, and we can, you know, make it smaller and blend it together. All right, so with that doing much, we can now start our frequency separation. So Ctrl J twice, you know how to do frequency separation. I'm gonna quickly do this and then we'll come back to the video. So I'm done with the frequency separation, and frequency separation is a lot of tutorial online for frequency separation. It's actually separating the texture and the color so you can work on them independently. So this is what we have before and after. So let me zoom in. This is before and then this is after. All right, so after that, I'd like to correct some skin variation color, or skin color variation, and I'm going to use the hue and adjustment saturation layer. In saturation adjustment layer, so just pick on the eye and drop tool. And why I want to fix this, I feel I want to make this part under cheek, or under mouth, yeah, sorry, also under cheek, look more like this other part. So I'm just gonna pick on the side, and you see the red is selected. So let's increase the hue and increase the slider to the lighter part to get those place selected, just because it's actually the lightest part in the image. So I'm just gonna do that quickly. So let's adjust this one backwards, and then take this slider forward and take this one also forward, and we can hit M on the keyboard. Oh sorry, I thought it's capture one. We can hit 0 back on this one, the U, and we can zoom in, and let's zoom in so we know what we're doing. Let's adjust till we have something similar. Okay, I guess that actually fixed what we want, so you can see before and then after. We can still push it in the more to get more of this color, so you can see before and then after. So it's all looking uniform right away. All right, so next thing we're gonna do is to whiten the teeth and the eyes, and for that I'm going to use the photo filter and combining it with the black and white adjustment layer. So on the color filter, choose the cooling filter 82, which also acts as white balance at times, and you can also use the black and white and group the two together. And let's make the two, but sometimes it doesn't look real. I'm gonna combine the two and I'm gonna make a max on the group. So this is for whitening. Okay, so now let's invert the mask, control I, and pick, select the brush tool, and we're gonna paint on the teeth. Okay, and sometimes when it doesn't work, you can combine the other tools such as the hue and saturation. So I'm going to be careful so it doesn't affect other places. So yeah, somewhere like this. Hit X again. Okay, so hit X and I'm gonna remove it from the gum. Okay, and we have it like this, and also this part I just don't want to use. The solid color method, because there are so many methods you can use to do this. Okay, so we can actually decrease the effect right now, so I have something close, and we can open it up and decrease this one, the part actually the white, black and white, which is actually making it look. So we can decrease the black and white something like 25, looks good to me. So let's zoom in and see, so you can see that it's actually the black and white. So you can even turn it off, you can turn it on. I prefer turning it on to make things look. I'm gonna turn it off then. I'll probably reduce it so much by 2% just to make things look, make things look natural. Okay, so now we can go to filter and finalize the photo. Create a stand visible layer and go to filter, camera raw filter. So here we are in camera raw filter. We didn't do dodging and burning, but I'm just gonna try use the white, the basic tool. So I'm gonna increase the highlight. Just increase the highlight and probably decrease the, let's increase the white too, and bring this one back a little bit, and let's bring back the shadows to create more. Bring down the shadows. We can increase the blacks. Let's try and decrease the black. Okay. Now I can increase the texture too, and the vibrance. And I guess I'm done with the basic. I'm going to go to the curve and create an X curve. So just tap up and tap down and bring down, bring this one up, something like that. You can turn it off and on to see off and on, just a little bit change. Let's go to the color mixer, and I feel like yeah, the red is too much, so I want the red to look okay. This is zero, reset. Go to the saturation. Let's start with the U. Let the red look like the orange, something like that. And the yellows look like the more like the orange too. Can go to the saturation and make the saturation of the red. Yeah, like the red. I guess we're missing out something. I'm gonna make the red look like the red just because of our lips. But there are some red present in some places. I guess we can fix that. We can actually fix that later. Let's make the red look like the orange. Go to the saturation of the red, and I'm gonna leave it the yellows, make the yellows saturated. I think I'm done with the color mixer. Let's go to the calibration. In another calibration, increase the red to somewhere around 20 and take the blues back, just the same way we normally do, and to get the proper adjustment. I guess we are going to reduce, just find the sweet spot for both. I guess the red is too much, so just bring it back till you have a sweet spot for it. So I'm looking for a sweet spot for the red and blues. So -4, and let's see with the red. Guess 1917. I'm gonna take this one back a little and restart. So I guess that place looks fine. 17. So that's 17. I'm gonna bring it back to 14 and let's see. I'm looking at the image while I'm adjusting this, so I can turn it off and on to see just the adjustment. And I guess that's okay. I click on OK and we have this, so you can see before and then after. So one thing I would like to do is to actually decrease the saturation of some places. So grab the U and saturation, and I know this place is actually too saturated, so I'm just gonna pick that place, increase the U, and let's look at how I'm gonna select that place alone. So I think it's selected already, and I'm going to hit 0 to reset that back, and we're just gonna touch the saturation and bring it back, not too much, just a bit, so you can see before and then after. Saturation has been decreased. Okay, so after that, I actually want to make a mask because I want the lips to look the way it is. So I'm gonna make a mask on the real image, and I'm going to use the brush tool and paint with black to hide that particular side, which is here. So you can see it won't affect. Yeah, so I want it looking natural, so something like this with the gum. Okay, so we're actually done with the photo, and we can just create another adjustment layer, which is U and saturation, and I'm gonna drag the mask, hold it down Alt and drag it onto the U and saturation, and I'm gonna click OK. And why I did that is because I just want to make the saturation of the, you know, the lips. Let's invert the mask so it affects just the lips alone. Okay, so I guess that's too much right now. Can bring it back a little by 9. And let's do some, lastly, some color grading. Go select the color balance, and we can add some blues. Go to the shadows, add some blues, just a bit. I like doing just little color grading. So to see the one that works fine, plus 6, you can add in some, let's make this one 0, and go to the highlight, and I feel the highlight needs some yellows and just a little bit. Let's add some greens and put some cyan, and the midtones you can either choose cyan. Okay, so that's okay for me. So you can see the before and then the after, just a little change, and then the after corrected a little more. All right, so let's create this time visible layer and see overall adjustment. So I'm gonna hold and shift to group everything together and turn it off, and we can see before and then after, before and then after. All right, so if you enjoyed the video, kindly like the video. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe. Once again, this is Asus.